Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
It goes on and on and on and on. Strangers waiting up and down the boulevard, and shadows searching in the night.
Lost and somewhere in the night.
We're almost at the Ramada.
The
Romeo. There's the Ramada.
Guys, we're here.
What? We're at States.
I'm looking at
States.
The
States.
States.
Everybody wants a thrill.
Chinese food here, Chinese food here.
Hey!
Chinese food
here.
Showtime!
Yes.
Alright.
Why?
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 Why? Hello.
Hi,
all my name is Candy, and I'm having hot flashes.
Are you going through menopause?
When you're having a dream.
Did you
say miracle metal?
Calling the toll-free number for godservices.org. To speak with someone on our own team about your questions or spiritual needs, press 0. To learn more about drbillboards.org.
I want to learn more about Dr. Billboard.
Alright, we finished our thing and now we're going to get late in the hotel room.
Hold
on a minute! Oh yeah!
Hey, where Anatomy of Grey all started.
There's germs at the corner cafe.
I wouldn't have said that because she was behind you. The girl who works here.
No, it's a line from our thing. You'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. Remember those walls I built? Maybe they're tumbling down, and they didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make the sound. I found a way to let you in, but I never really had a doubt. Standing in the light of your halo, I got my angel now. It's like I've been awakened. Every rule I had you breaking. It's the risk that I'm taking.
Thank you, thank you. I'd like to thank the Academy for... Wait, wrong speech, sorry. Hey, what is up, you guys? So, thought I'd do my YouTube intro, for old time's sake. Hudkins. Words can't describe how I feel right now, making this video finally. I can't just say thank you for all you've done, because you've truly changed my life for the better. And you've molded me into the actor I am today, and... I can say that I never expected any of this. I never expected to be thespian officer, president, student thespian officer, or state thespian officer.
If you guys are going to the regionals, you better vote for me for the, I forget what it's called.
Each year, it's been a different experience, and the only thing that never changes is the family aspect of theater. Despite all the drama, at the end of the day, we all came together and we were a family.
We're all in a bed together.
This is gay.
David, you're pretty gay, so.
And that's the most important thing about theater. One thing I'm definitely going to miss is the trips to states, New York, anywhere, because it's not like a regular field trip. It's an experience. Alright, see you later, Hudkins. Hope you have good luck with your next shows next year, and I will come see them.
Hey, Hudkins. I just wanted to say farewell. Although I didn't get great roles, I had a lot of fun being on stage and being backstage and being a part of theater. It really made me feel like I was a part of something since I'm not that great at sports. And I had a lot of fun at States last year. I wish I would have gotten to go to States this year, but it was a kind of hard cast.
This reminds me of the Hippodrome in Baltimore.
Oh my god, yes!
It does look like that.
I had really a lot of fun in Theater 1, and I feel like that's what started my love for theater. And I loved being in Shrek, being stage crew. I thought I was the coolest freshman in the world because I was in Shrek, even though I was just stage crew. And I really appreciate all that you've done for the theater, and keep doing what you're doing, I guess.
Okay, so I just want to thank Mr. Heckins. I want to thank you so much for making theater a part of my life and giving me a chance as a freshman, because I honestly thought my audition sucked. But thank you for having some faith in me, and because of you, I'm where I am today, and I've incorporated theater in a big part of my life. I want to say thank you to my theater family for making me feel included, and I love you all very much. Mr. Heckins, if you ever need anything, don't hesitate to hit me up. Just know I love you. I know it's kind of sentimental, but you're a really big role model in my life, and without you, I don't know who I would be, to be honest, because honestly, theater was way better than cheer. So, yeah, I'm kind of glad that, not kind of glad, I'm very glad that you allowed me to become a part of your theater family. It's only farewell for now, but I will be coming to see future productions like Clue and Once on This Island, which is my favorite musical. So, thank you for incorporating me into your theater family. I love you so much, and I'll miss you. Bye!
Hi, Edkins. So, I want to start off by saying thank you. Thank you for being so welcoming. I mean, the whole entire theater community was welcoming when I first did my first play, and you were very welcoming, and I'm really thankful that you actually gave me a chance and put some work into me. And I'm thankful that you're always there and you made theater a home. I mean, you always made theater feel like a safe place, somewhere we could go if we were having a bad day, or somewhere to go after exams.
You're not Hudkins.
Who
do you think you are?
Hudkins.
To unwind, you know, somewhere to go if we didn't have any friends at lunch that day. Everyone is at home, you know, we could go to the auditorium and just hang out, and you just made theater genuinely feel like a home. And you helped us all build relationships with each other, and you helped us all blossom into amazing people. I mean, if it wasn't for you and everyone in theater, I mean, I wouldn't be as outgoing as I am, and I would still be that really shy kid. And I have a lot to thank you for, but I also wanted to apologize for being late to class pretty much every day and not showing up to class a lot and missing rehearsals. And I'm just really sorry that I wasn't the best student at times. And I know you didn't really like that, and I feel bad about it still, I'm sorry. But thank you for everything, Hudkins.
Breezy. I know this very well, this is like the fourth take I've taken on this. And I'm sure that everyone in the audience wants to go home at this point, it's probably pretty late. But I just want to say thank you for all that you've done. You've been like a father to me, and I've gone pretty far in this life because of you, so thank you. And as for all of you juniors and freshmen and sophomores, make sure to get to know each other very well. You never know when it's going to come in handy to have a friend at your side.
What's up, guys? It's YJ here, and this is my farewell video to Jeff Hudkins and Molly Hudkins, the two lovebirds that we all know and love. Ha ha ha! Oh man, so just want to make this short and sweet. Mr. Hutchins and Molly, you both are amazing individuals. You have truly mentored me. You taught me three things in my life, to have open creativity, to be fearless in entertainment, and to use praise and compliments to inspire others to continue on with their lives.
Hey, YJ.
I'm really gonna miss you guys. You know, Mob here, he's really gonna miss being on stage, right, Mob? Oh, man! Nah, I'm kidding. Mob loves me, right, Mob? Mwah! See? I'm really gonna miss you guys. You've been amazing. It's been one hell of a ride at being here at HHS Theater, so take care. Mwah! And as for the rest of you, theater kids, my one advice is never go with your original script. Be an inspiration, be an entertainment to all, and remember to always tell yourself, you're one with the crowd, this is me.
Egypt will prevail!
What?
And that's it, yeah, that's really about it. So I love you guys, be awesome, and I look forward to see you if I ever visit, if I actually ever visit, so... Bye!
Hey, Hudkins. Just wanted to say thank you for allowing me to be part of the theater program here at Hedgesville. It's a true honor to be part of something so special like this. It's helped me grow in so many aspects of my life. I wouldn't be able to do half the things I do now without being a part of theater. Just from Midsummer to our special town in Zion and Diviners, and just Aida was wonderful, and The Little Mermaid was like so special to be a part of, and I just want to thank you for giving me those opportunities. I guess see you around.
Good evening, Mr. Hudkins. It's Dalton. I haven't known you that long, only the past few years, but every morning, probably for the past 4 years, whenever you did play music in the lobby in the mornings, that was probably one of my favorite memories, is when you'd play pentatonics or Christmas music, or you played Once on This Island or Aida or Little Mermaid. It was just my favorite part, and that was one of my favorite memories because I never did have you in theater class, but when we were in theater productions together, it was different. It was something different, it was out of orchestra. But it was nice. It was a really nice experience to be in theater and to do shows that I've never been able to do before. And I really think this past year has been probably one of my favorite years. And I really loved Aida, but The Little Mermaid was probably the highlight of my senior year. And I don't think that could have been possible without you. So thank you for creating me as an actor and helping so many kids grow better in theater and everything. Just thank you.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.